MIT Cables founder Bruce Brisson began designing audio cables in the 1970s after encountering the sonic problems inherent in virtually all cables of the day. He then founded Music Interface Technologies in 1984 after patenting and licensing his early designs to other manufacturers, creating some of the audio industry's most revered and groundbreaking interfaces. Over the ensuing three decades, MIT Cables continues as the technology leader in audio and video cabling, as well as AC power line treatment and conditioning. MIT Cables are used to interface the finest professional recording and film studios throughout the world. MIT Cables' core audio technology is our exclusive Poles of Articulation, named after the fact that every cable has a single point in the audio frequency range where it is most efficient at storing and releasing energy, and will therefore articulate best. This point represents that cable's particular articulation pole and defines the cable's sonic signature. For example, a cable that has its articulation pole located at a low frequency might be described by some audiophiles as being warm, while others may describe it as being muddy or veiled. Conversely, a cable that has its articulation pole located at a higher frequency might be described by audiophiles as fast or detailed, while others may describe it as harsh or forward. Note also the areas of over-articulation for these two cables where their respective articulation plots exceed the ideal line. In these regions, the cable will project an overemphasized or forward presentation in that segment of the audible frequency range. To overcome these limitations inherent in normal cables, we provide our exclusive poles of articulation, which are passive networks that may be installed within the enclosures on the cable that we are known for, or with our recent advances in miniaturization, we can install these networks within the connectors of the cable. We optimize our poles of articulation to operate at frequencies based upon the harmonic content of music. Together, our poles of articulation work synergistically to increase the interface's bandwidth of articulation, thereby transporting your audio content with a more even response than just a single cable. Our products are distinguished by the number of poles of articulation. The farther up our line in price you go, the more poles of articulation are present in the interface, and hence, the better performance in a given system. For example, a Matrix 3 interconnect includes three poles of articulation, shown here as plots A, B, and C. This results in a bandwidth of articulation represented here by the blue line. Compared to just cable, you'll hear better bass, better mid-range, and better highs. Conversely, a Matrix 6 interconnect includes six poles of articulation, shown here as plots A through F. Six poles of articulation provide an even wider bandwidth of articulation, represented here by the yellow line. Now note that in the Matrix 6 plot, there are multiple regions where the poles of articulation overlap one another. These intersecting regions provide increased density in the presentation, resulting in a more realistic timbre and richer textures throughout the audio spectrum. Compared to the Matrix 3 interconnect, with the Matrix 6, you'll hear deeper bass, enhanced image and focus, and an overall greater clarity. Finally, here is the Matrix 6 bandwidth of articulation shown against the two competitors' cables discussed earlier. Note that the yellow bandwidth line of the Matrix 6 encompasses the combined response of both cables. This demonstrates how our multipole technology provides the results of multiple cables in one.